DayZ 1.24 has been out for a week now, and it includes a laundry list of new additions, changes, and fixes, some of which are going to seriously change a few metas and more. Let's dive in with more detail. One of the best, if not the best, thing in DayZ 1.24 are the changes made to weaponries. They've changed the collision checks for the mechanic entirely, allowing you to get quite a bit closer to corners, windows, walls, and more without having your weapon rays nearly as easily or as often when moving. Weapon sway also doesn't affect the weapon rays anywhere near as much now, which means you won't have to deal with this anymore, hopefully. With this, they've also changed the calculation of weapon length for more accurate collision detection. It's not exactly perfect, but it is still night and day in terms of how bad it was before and where it is as of 1.24. Unfortunately, trying to aim out of or near windows is still really finicky, leading to a lot of the same issues we've always had with weapon rays all these years. It is a bit better, but there seems to be an issue right now where once you look back at a safe spot after having your weapon raised, it won't lower until you stop aiming and aim again, which is game breaking. Hopefully this gets ironed out, otherwise the only real improvement made with these changes is being able to shoot around corners without having weapon sway lead to weapon raise. And of course, everyone is probably most excited for the new weapon, the Vakir. The SR3 Vakir is a compact assault rifle chambered in the 9x3 9mm cartridge. With its small size, insanely fast fire rate at 900 RPM, and a considerable 75 damage per round, this is going to be one of the scarier weapons to come across in close quarters PvP. The Vakir accepts all AK optics and only AK optics. However, its accuracy at range is nothing short of horrible, and 9x39 doesn't exactly travel fast, so it's best to keep this one by your side, specifically for CQB. Unfortunately, the only suppressor we can put on the Vakir as of now is the improvised suppressor. East suppressor does not work, and I assume it'll stay that way in order to not power creep the VSS and the VAL. It should also be noted that the Vakir is considerably smaller than the VSS and the VAL, both when held by the player character and when in the inventory, allowing you to store the Vakir in larger jackets and smaller bags. Along with the Vakir, 1.24 introduces the 30-round Vakir mag, holding 30 rounds in 9x39. This mag can be used not only by the Vakir, but the VSS and the VAL as well, including armor-piercing rounds to really eat through those players that wear plate carriers. Previously, we only had 10-round and 20-round mags for the VSS and VAL, but these 30-round mags honestly could change a lot in the close quarters PvP meta, essentially giving us another weapon that is just as good as an M4, if not better due to its small size. Another massive change. Using bandages, rags, and sewing kits on bleeds are now continuous actions. You can now simply hold down left mouse until you either heal all of your wounds or until you consume your bandage, rag, or sewing kit entirely. Even though this seems like a minor change, this can change the outcome of so many situations, whether it be against infected or in PvP or both. This one is actually a real game changer. Guns now have the chance of spawning with any combination of having or not having a magazine or round in the chamber. Some pistols will even spawn with their slide open or closed now, so we'll have a bit of a harder time telling if a player is or has been around because of dropped weapons. Prior to 1.24, guns with mags would never spawn with a bullet in the chamber, and pistols with no mag would never spawn with their slide open, making it very easy to tell that the weapon you just found spawned there and was not dropped by a player. And I know if you play DayZ, you probably know where the weapons spawn, but not everybody plays the game full time to know where each and every spawn location is, so this at the very least will make the game more immersive for newer players or people who haven't played as much as others. No more excuses to not wear a helmet. We've got three new variants of the ballistic helmet, including Woodland Camo, Digital Desert Camo, and Digital Flecktarn Camo. Even though they look new and different, these are still the same old ballistic helmet we've had for years, stats and all. But at least now we can finally complete our outfits and play DayZ in style. In addition to new variants of existing items, we've also got entirely new sounds for certain actions, such as crafting improvised clothing from rags, crafting base building kits, crafting bone knives, wringing out wet clothing, splitting firewood, although I couldn't get this sound to happen, so I don't have an example of that, and breaking down bushes with your hands. Also added were new unique animations for cleaning your hands with the cooking pot and gasoline canister, which also means we can now wash our hands with gasoline. Quite a bit of changes to the melee system have been made this patch, giving blunt weapons a boost when fighting against infected and animals. Prior to 1.24, shock damage did not affect animals or infected, as far as I'm concerned, but as of now, shock damage partially translates into health damage. Even with these changes, it seems that the fire axe is currently the only melee weapon capable of one-hitting infected, leaving the change to blunt weapons feeling lacking. You're still better off with just your fists or brass knuckles. Also, related to melee, they have finally fixed the glitch that essentially allowed people to continue heavy melee attacking even when out of stamina, so no more getting stunlocked by bug abusers. Can't believe it took this long to fix this issue, but at least it's finally fixed. Some weapon changes have also been introduced, and you're probably either going to hate them or love them. No in between. The Vyga's rate of fire and recoil have both been reduced. Recoil for several automatic firearms have been increased, making them a little bit harder to control. Guns now visually overheat and smoke more frequently, however, this still does nothing but give your position away. Pistol suppressors have been changed and actually seem to work again. Kind of. Not really, but we'll get into that soon in another video. Other small changes that should still be noted include the SKS having new sounds, rebalanced weight for tools and melee weapons, minor clothing insulation changes, less collision with tree branches and fallen foliage on the ground and forest, and a more simplified collision system for trees, hopefully meaning that leaves, branches, and trees in general don't eat our bullets as much. However, since that change, trees feel really snaggy and nasty when you get close to them. Oh, and Lukov Airfield got a reskin for you Livonia players out there. There's a bunch of other stuff to check out in this patch, but I just wanted to share what I thought was the core and important parts of this update with you. So if you're interested in seeing the full list of additions, changes, and fixes, I've linked the patch list in the description for you to check out yourself. Hit that like button if you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.